In today's video, we're going to be discussing 8 signs you have a carbohydrate intolerance and what that means for your health. Now, this is a really interesting topic because we have long been told that carbohydrates should make up over half of the calories we eat every day. However, there is a genetic component, which means that a percentage of the population cannot actually digest and process carbohydrates properly. Not only will these individuals experience a wide range of side effects when they eat carbohydrates, but they are also at a greater risk of obesity if they do. But there is actually another reason you might be carbohydrate intolerant, and that is related to lifestyle. So in today's video, we're going to go over 8 symptoms of a carbohydrate intolerance and discuss what that means for your health. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by SelfDecode, a genetics testing and analysis company that gives you personalized health recommendations based on your genes. To check them out, you can head to healthcoachkate.com/selfdecode. So what exactly is a carbohydrate intolerance? Carbohydrate intolerance is the inability of the body to completely process carbohydrates. This can be due to a deficiency of one of the enzymes needed for carbohydrate digestion. This enzyme is amylase, which is in saliva, and its purpose is to break down starch. This enzyme is related to the AMY1 gene. People who have more copies of this gene produce more amylase and are better able to digest and process carbs. And on the flip side, people with a lower number of this gene do not process carbs well and are considered carb intolerant. We're gonna start off by talking about 8 symptoms of a carb intolerance, and make sure to stick around until the end to find out if your carb intolerance is actually due to lifestyle factors. Number 1, bloating. As I mentioned earlier, a deficiency in amylase can mean that your body isn't able to properly break down starch. Usually when we eat foods that contain starch, the molecules are broken down into glucose, and amylase plays a part in breaking it down. So if our bodies are not producing enough amylase, this can mean the carbs are sitting in our stomach and colon indigested, then they ferment, which creates gas, and then bloating. And I really wanted to mention this symptom first because over the last couple of years, there's been this trend to normalize bloating. Women and men, but I've mostly seen it from women, are posting photos of before and after they eat. And the bloating some of these people experience is insane. Now, this movement is coming from a good place, one of body positivity. However, just because bloating is common does not mean it is normal, and especially if you are experiencing it so severely. Now, there are a few reasons why someone might be bloated after they eat, and a carb intolerance is one of these reasons. So if you're someone who experiences bloating after eating, this might be a sign that your body isn't able to process carbs well. Number 2, fatigue. So next up, we have fatigue. If your body is not properly able to process carbs, then it is not able to turn them into energy, and this can result in fatigue. When our glucose metabolism is not functioning properly, we can experience big swings in energy levels. For a metabolically healthy individual who can process carbs properly, eating them will result in a surge of energy. However, if you are carb intolerant, this might not happen. Number 3 is afternoon sugar cravings. And this symptom is linked with the last one, fatigue. Because your body is not able to properly utilize the carbs you're consuming and turn them into energy, this can cause you to crave more glucose and cause cravings for sugar. This is your body trying to force you to give it this energy. However, if you aren't processing the carbohydrates efficiently, this can lead to an endless cycle of cravings. Number 4, gas. We already spoke about bloating, but bloating and gas go hand in hand. As previously mentioned, when carbs are not digested, they might end up sitting in the stomach or the colon. Here they will ferment, and this fermentation causes gas. So if you're someone who is constantly gassy after eating, this might be a sign of a carbohydrate intolerance. Now, before I get into the last four signs of a carbohydrate intolerance, I'm going to take a moment to tell you about today's sponsor, Self-Decode, and how you can use them to find out if you are carb intolerant or not. Self-Decode is a genetics testing and analysis company that gives you personalized health recommendations based on your genes. We all have a different set of genes, and understanding our genetic predispositions can help us to understand whether our diet and lifestyle choices are working for or against us. And Self-Decode makes understanding and applying this information easy. Earlier in today's video, we were speaking about the AMY1 gene, which is related to how well your body can tolerate carbs. And Self-Decode actually has a blog post on their website titled, "How Does This Salivary Enzyme Affect Weight Gain?" This blog post explains how this gene expression can affect your weight. The article states, lower expression of AMY1A has been associated with a higher body mass index and obesity. This was shown in multiple studies with over 7,500 people. For example, one study suggests a person with less than 4 copies might have an 8-fold higher risk of obesity compared to a person with over 9 copies. Based on my genetic test results, my AMY1A gene is somewhat associated with abnormal or excessive weight gain. Self-Decode suggests I reduce carbs in my diet, avoid late-night snacking, and do moderate intensity exercise. It then goes to back up each of these recommendations with multiple studies. If you have already done a DNA test, you can upload your file to the Self-Decode website. And if not, you can order a DNA kit from them directly. And Self-Decode also has an online lab shop where you can order tests such as fasting blood sugar and insulin straight to your door. Currently, the lab tests are only available in the US, but their DNA testing and analysis is available worldwide. And Self-Decode members save 50% off lab tests. If you want to check out Self-Decode, you can head to healthcoachkate.com/self-decode, and I will put the link in the description box down below as well. Thank you again to Self-Decode for sponsoring this video. Number 5, nausea. Again, the symptom comes back to our bodies not being able to digest carbohydrates. This can lead to you feeling sick after eating them. Number 6, abdominal cramps. A lot of people with a carb intolerance experience a gurgly belly and even abdominal cramps after eating. This is, of course, not how you want to feel after you eat, but this symptom can sometimes be explained by a carb intolerance. Number 7, brain fog. The next symptom we're going to talk about today is brain fog. And this ties in with not being able to properly break down carbs into glucose. Glucose is the main fuel source for the brain, and if the brain isn't getting enough glucose, you might experience brain fog. Now, I just want to mention that the brain can use ketones for energy, and your body can also make glucose internally. So it's not as though you have to eat carbs in order to not experience brain fog. But if you are not fat adapted and your body is not making ketones readily, then this might not be an option. Number 8, increased hunger. Again, this symptom is due to the fact that your body isn't able to properly utilize the food you are eating, and therefore it is causing you to remain hungry and experience cravings. And those are 8 symptoms of a carb intolerance. Now, before we wrap up, I just want to say that even if you don't have the gene expression that means that you have low levels of amylase, you can still be carbohydrate intolerant. Let me explain. Now, if you have watched any of my other videos, I'm sure you know where I'm going with this, because this is a topic I've talked about a lot, and that is insulin resistance. Insulin resistance is when our cells are not responding to the actions of insulin correctly and not taking in the correct amount of glucose, aka our body is not able to process carbs efficiently, aka carbohydrate intolerance. It is estimated that 88% of Americans are insulin resistant, which is a crazy high number, but also not entirely shocking when you see the state of metabolic health in the Western world. And insulin resistance is caused by lifestyle factors, mainly diet. Now, I won't go into insulin resistance and the cause of it too much today, just for the sake of time, but I do have another video that goes a lot deeper, which I will link above, and I highly recommend checking that video out if you aren't familiar with insulin resistance. So, to recap the symptoms of a carbohydrate intolerance, 1, bloating, 2, fatigue, 3, sugar cravings, 4, gas, 5, nausea, 6, abdominal cramps, 7, brain fog, and 8, increased hunger. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you experience any of these symptoms and if you think you might be carbohydrate intolerant. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already. And if you have a friend or family member, or maybe you're in a Facebook group that you think would find this video helpful, feel free to share it. I appreciate you guys sharing my videos, and yeah, I appreciate it. Remember to check out today's sponsor, Self-Decode. The link to check them out will be in the description box down below. And if you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on what insulin resistance is, which I mentioned earlier. You can check it out right here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find them here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.